Hello and welcome. My name is Kathleen McGowan and thank you for joining me. In today's video, I'll be discussing the subject matter of vitamins, more specifically synthetic vitamins versus natural whole food derived vitamins. I share this important information with you, information that I've found that most people are not yet aware of, and that is the difference between a synthetic vitamin and a 100% whole food vitamin, and why it's vital for you to understand what is what. The background to what prompted me to begin sharing this information several years ago, in short, is that I have a very good friend who once owned a large nutritional supplement company. And he, of course, had been taking his own supplements on a daily basis for years. And during one of his business trips in Asia, he became very ill and was taken to the hospital. Now, upon examination, it was found that he had severe liver damage. And I do wish to mention here that he was not a consumer of alcohol and that he did eat in a very healthy manner. However, his severely toxic liver had placed him in a potentially life-threatening situation. It took some time, actually a great deal of time, in getting to the root of what caused his alarming situation. And I say alarming because he was considered to be a role model of health. When he finally did discover the cause, he was absolutely shocked to learn what the answer was. Although it had taken several years of him being on his own supplements, it was discovered that it was his very own supplements that were the root to his serious liver damage. And I also want to interject here that in my friend's case, he at that period of time absolutely believed he had products of genuine efficacy. It took a great deal of time, but thankfully he did finally recover. Having been through what that experience in life brought him through, he embarked on a journey of tremendous research and testing. And what he discovered is that it was his very own nutritional supplements that he had been taking himself for years that were made of synthetic vitamins. And it was that was at the root of what nearly killed him. He didn't know at the time that they were synthetic because he had never been provided information on what synthetic vitamins and their sources were, let alone that there was a world out there of such a thing of 100% whole food derived vitamins. It was at that time, through extensive research, that he learned what synthetic vitamins are actually derived from. And with this knowledge, he finally understood how it came about that his very own vitamins almost killed him. To summarize what happened next is that he became an expert in understanding what synthetic vitamins are derived from and what potentially significant harmful effects they can have on your body. And it was after that period in time he learned of and became an expert also in what 100% whole food derived vitamins and nutritional supplementation was. This video and the vital information I'm about to share with you, I tribute to my dear friend. I am so blessed that we met on a plane many years ago, became close friends, and that he opened my eyes so that I could do in-depth research myself on this vitally important subject to everyone. So that's the background to why and how I became aware of the information that I'm about ready to share with you. So let's get started with this video subject matter now. And I'd like to begin by stating the obvious. Good health is no coincidence. It's been known for many years that you can trace every ailment, every sickness, and every disease to a vitamin mineral deficiency. And this was proven by Dr. Linus Pauling, a renowned scientist and two-time Nobel Prize winner. Chronic degenerative conditions take years, take decades to develop, as do wrinkles and fuzzy brains. Most people will not initially recognize the signs that their body's communicating to them as being side effects from ingesting small amounts of toxins found in the so-called food that they eat and what they drink, and the toxins that reside in the majority of vitamin supplements found in the marketplace today. It's extremely important to be aware of the fact that long-term consequences of continuous daily intakes of these toxins are dangerous. This video is going to focus on, as I mentioned earlier, the difference between whole food vitamins and synthetic vitamins, what the difference is, and then guide you to how you can easily find out if the vitamins you're currently putting into your body or considering putting into your body are either from whole food sources or from synthetic sources. Then in future videos, I'll share information with you about serious toxins that reside in the so-called food and beverages that most people, particularly in the United States, consume themselves and feed to their families every day. So let me ask you this. Are you aware, and I mean, do you truly understand that most vitamins in the marketplace today and are likely in your home right now are processed at high temperature, contain petroleum-derived chemical solvents such as coal tar derivatives and ethyl cellulose, and that they're coated with a carcinogenic material? These sources are not living foods. However, the majority of people still don't know the difference between a synthetic, a crystalline, and a whole food source vitamin. Or are they aware of the difference between an amino acid chelated organic and inorganic mineral? Living systems are very complex and specific in their needs for building materials. Our bodies have a precise design, which is incredibly intricate and complex. And just as if you were to build a house with cheap imitation construction materials, your house would quickly fall into despair. If you attempt to build your body with cheap imitation toxic materials, your body will sooner or later fall into despair, which is also known as chronic or degenerative conditions. We are a direct product of what we eat and the lifestyles we choose to live. Granted, there are conditions that are passed along to us genetically. However, even in those instances, research has shown that through proper nourishment and lifestyle changes, we can greatly reduce our risk of premature illness and death-causing conditions. So let's now gain a little further knowledge about what is what in regards to natural whole food derived vitamins versus synthetic vitamins. And then you decide for yourself to what makes just plain good old common sense. Some examples of natural sources of whole food vitamins are carrots, lemongrass, and omega-3s, versus an example of a synthetic vitamin source is from coal tar derived substances. Yes, you heard me correctly. I said coal tar derived substances. Your health is important. And if you or a loved one or a close friend have ever lost your good health, then you already understand that without it, what truly is important in life and what truly is not important becomes very clear very fast. Knowing if the vitamin supplements that you take are working for or against you is vital to know not only to you and your family's health, but to your lives. Making the choice that the vitamins you're putting into your body and giving to your children and other loved ones are synthetic or whole food, plant-based, and knowing if they're providing your bodies with the nourishment and not toxic chemicals. This will sooner or later either positively or negatively affect you, your health, and your life and that of your family. So to assist you in knowing what is what, I've placed a vitamin list that will provide you with information to determine if the vitamins you're taking or that you're interested in purchasing are from a synthetic source or a whole food plant-based source. To obtain this information and vitamin-derived list, please read my blog entitled What Track Will You Choose? Located on my website, bouldersoflife.com. When reviewing the information on my blog, please take a close look at the derived from when you're reviewing the synthetic vitamin names in the chart. And if you're not certain of what the potentially damaging effects of are the derived compounds, I highly recommend that you take a moment to Google them, because you and your loved one's health and your lives are worth the time in doing so. Please accept the fact that it is vitally important for you to look at the reality of what you're putting into your body and that of your children. And if changes that need to be made are not made, they could have devastating effect on all of you. So I thank you for spending this time with me. I look forward to being with you again. And as always, in peace, grace, and gratitude.